Now this right here is my boombox project from 7 years ago. And as you can see and hear, it still works perfectly fine. But recently I noticed that this LED charge level indicator here, that I also built from scratch, does not really represent the state of charge of my battery pack anymore. I mean, at one point it was showing me 40% charge left, and like half an hour later the boombox turned off, which does not correlate at all with the battery capacity and flowing current. So what is going on here? Well, in this video I will not only show you what is wrong with my charge level indicator, but also create a way better solution that is using modern technology pretty much everyone uses unknowingly, and which even notices when my battery ages. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Texas Instruments and Mauser Electronics, who not only create the magical ICs required to solve all of our battery problems, but Mauser is also currently hosting a contest where you can win some awesome prizes. So click the link below to check them out. Now to get started, let's have a look at my DIY charge level indicator. As you can see, it merely consists of mostly LEDs and some passive components, all built around two LM324 quad op amps. I use them here as comparators, meaning that if the applied battery voltage is higher than a threshold I set by hand, then the output turns on, aka an LED lights up. And when we measure all the threshold voltages and write them down, then they more or less follow a pretty well-known curve, and that is the discharge curve of a lithium-ion battery. By the way, my pack uses 4 lithium-ion batteries in series, which is the reason these voltages are 4 times bigger than when using a single battery. So when, for example, the battery is 40% full, then the voltage should be around 14.2 volts, and thus only the LEDs with the threshold under that light up. And therefore, we should have a pretty reliable charge level indicator. Right? Wrong, because this curve here is truly idealized. To prove that, let me show you a popular example using this battery pack. If we draw only a small current, like 1 amp, then the voltage goes down by around 150 millivolts. But when we draw more current, like 5 amps, then the voltage sag is noticeably bigger. That is why manufacturers pretty much always include multiple curves in such a diagram, that not only describes how the voltage behavior changes under various loads, but also with different temperatures, which also plays an important role. And let's not forget that my battery pack here is 7 years old, and thus its chemistry and therefore capacity and internal resistance changed as well, and not for the better. This also skews the voltage curve, which at this point should have made it clear that relying on voltage to determine the state of charge is not a good idea. And also, my favorite battery chemistry, LiFePO4, comes with such a flat discharge curve, where relying on voltages is pretty much impossible. So what can we do instead? Well, as you might know, pretty much every battery comes with a capacity, like here for example 600 milliamp hours. That means I can draw 600 milliamps from the battery for 1 hour before it is completely empty. But of course, almost no device draws constant current. Instead, the current flow over time could look something like this, with a nominal current that spikes from time to time. And if we now add up all the area beneath this curve, then you guessed it, we got the milliamp hours we just used. And if we deduct that from 600 milliamp hours as 100%, then we got the state of charge. So measuring the current is the way to go, and devices that use this technique are called fuel gauges. Your smartphone uses that, big batteries, my electric vehicle, and even my PV system use that, with this big shunt. Such a shunt is more or less a super tiny resistor, across which a voltage drop occurs when current is flowing. And since we know current equals voltage divided by resistance, we can calculate the current that we desperately need. So with the basics out of the way, I firstly thought about creating a DIY fuel gauge. I mean, how hard can it be to measure current and integrate that over time to get the discharged or charged milliamp hour value, and then translate that into an SOC value? But then I remembered that aging of my pack and a change in characteristics was one of my big problems, and implementing that in DIY would require lots of research and effort. So instead I searched through the internet to find a suitable IC, and luckily for me, Texas Instruments have been producing fuel gauge ICs for years now. And truth be told, their newest IC generation with dynamic Z-tracking seemed pretty perfect for my aging battery pack. However, the required circuit for it is a bit too complex to get my feet wet when it comes to fuel gauges. So my second idea was to use this a bit older BQ34Z100, which is also great for aging packs, works with lots of chemistries, single and multi-cell packs, and comes with a more manageable application schematic. So I created a breakout board for it, sawed out all the components in place, and did lots of testing, only to ultimately figure out that it is also a bit too ambitious. I mean, I would probably eventually get it to work, but for now I think we should look at something even simpler. And that was the moment I found a breakout board around the BQ27441 IC, which is a fuel gauge whose schematic is possibly as simple as it can get. You pretty much only need a 10 milliohm shunt resistor to measure the current and two capacitors for decoupling. That is it. And the IC is still suited for aging batteries, since it keeps track of chemical, electrical, and external information to precisely determine the state of the battery. The only real downside is that it only works with single-cell lithium-ion batteries, meaning let's ignore my boombox for now and let's get familiar with fuel gauges using this also old single-cell and this breakout board that you can honestly get for pretty cheap. And of course, it comes with some more components than what I mentioned before, because those offer a bit more convenience. All we have to do to use it is to firstly hook up our lithium-ion battery. But be careful about the polarity, because my connector was switched around. After that, we simply have to connect the power and I2C pins to a microcontroller, like in my case an Arduino Nano. At this point, we could use the datasheet to understand what I2C commands to send, but to make our life easier, we can also simply use the given pre-made Arduino library that actually originated from SparkFun. Props to them. Here we can find the extended configuration example sketch, where we simply have to edit the battery capacity, in my case 2500 mAh. We can leave the lowest battery voltage at 3 volts, and that charging ends below a current of 125 mA. Just like the battery datasheet tells us. So after uploading and opening the serial monitor, it seems like the board connected successfully, and we got a whole bunch of interesting information here, like the state of charge, voltage, current, usable capacity and full capacity, power and state of health. So next I firstly checked whether the voltage and current measurement was accurate, and it was pretty much spot on. However, at this point I doubted that the SOC and everything related to it was accurate, because in order to get precise values, we firstly need to discharge the battery and then completely fill it up again. While doing that, the fuel gauge keeps track of everything and updates parameters like, for example, the max capacity, that ultimately turned out to be 2384 mAh. To confirm that, I discharged the battery completely once more with my battery tester, that in the end told me a similar story about the capacity. And the state of health of around 90% also sounds plausible, because this battery is almost 8 years old and was stored pretty badly, meaning its capacity and resistance is probably not the very best anymore. So yeah, I feel like I can trust this fuel gauge, meaning by adding an OLED display to the mix and altering the code, we basically got a smart battery cell here about whose state of charge I will always know about. Only shame is that it does not work for my multi-cell battery, but I will sooner or later also find a solution for that, so stay tuned. Until then, I hope you enjoyed this show and learned something new. If so, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!